Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. In today's video, from mathematics, lines and angles topic we are going to discuss. So let's start with the angle, children. So already in our previous classes we have learned about angle. So let's revise once about the concept of angle. So here, children, so angle means it's an inclination. It's an inclination. It's an inclination between two rays. This is the one ray and this is the second ray. The inclination between the two rays is called as angle. But the two rays should have one common point. This ray is OA ray. This ray is OA ray. This ray is OB ray. But in the two rays, O is the common point. Then the inclination at point O is called as an angle. So this common initial point is called as vertex. This common initial point is called as vertex. Vertex of the angle. And the two rays, OA ray and OB ray, are called arms of the angle. Arms of the angle. So here, this O, common point O, is the vertex of the angle. Common point O is the vertex and vertex of the angle. Or we can also denote it as A O B. Angle A O B. Like that also we can denote that angle. So angle O, angle AOB is the place where the angle is formed or is the angle of inclination. Here O is called vertex of the angle. The two rays are called arms of the angles. OA bar is one arm. OB bar is second arm. And the symbol for angle is this one, this symbol. This is the symbol of angle. So actually, angle is usually named by three-letter notation, like this AOB, three letters. So this point, this common initial point will come in the middle, and other ray, other point will come at the end. So one point of one arm, A is one point of first arm, O is the common initial point, and B is the one point of second arm. One point of second arm. Like this, angle is normally a three-letter combination. Three-letter combination. Not only AOB, we can also name it as angle BOA. We can also name it as angle BOA. B point we can take first, but there will be no change. Angle AOB is same as angle BOA. But at point O, we don't have any other angle except this angle. So only one angle is there. So that's why we can directly mention it as angle O. Like that also we can mention. Measurement. Angle as rotation. Angle as rotation. So in the previous definition, what we have learned, inclination between the two rays is called as an angle. That we have told. Inclination between two rays we have told. But we can also define angle as a rotation. So instead of two rays, we can take a single ray. We can take a single ray. So an angle is also thought of as the figure formed by rotating the single ray about its vertex. Instead of taking two rays, we can take single ray. If this is OA ray, if this is OA ray, if this OA ray is rotating, if it is rotated up to here, about this vertex O, now this A point reached to a new point A dash, then this is the angle of inclination. So there is no compulsory that for formation of angle we need two rays. Single ray also, it can rotate about its vertex, and that rotation part is taken as an angle, that rotation part, because this is the amount of rotation done by this OA ray. This amount of rotation is called measure of the angle. So normally we use the symbol degree, means in the exponent place, suppose if it is 30 degrees, in the exponent place, if you take 0, so this is the symbol of degree. So degree symbolized as this exponent 0 is a unit of measuring angles. So angles can be measured with the help of unit called degrees. With the help of unit called degrees. Suppose a single ray, this OA ray, if it has made complete rotation and again came back to the same place. So about O, about vertex O, it has made a rotation of this one complete rotation. The single ray has made one complete rotation. So one complete turn or rotation about the vertex, it is divided into 360 equal parts, and each part is equal to 1 degree. Each part equal to 1 degree. We are making it into 360 equal parts. We are making into 360 equal parts, and each part is having a value of 1 degree. So altogether, one complete turn will be having a value of 360 into 1, 360 degrees. So 360 degrees is the measurement of one complete angle, measurement of one complete rotation. So this measurement is called complete angle. Complete angle means 360 degrees. Rotation angle made by one complete rotation. So this 360 degrees part, this 360 degree part, again it is divided into 60 equal parts. Like this, it is divided into 60 equal parts. Divided into 60 equal parts. So each part is called as a minute. Each part is called as a minute. So we have 360 degrees, but that 360 degrees divided into 60 parts, which is equal to 60 minutes. 60 minutes means 1 minute. 1 minute equal to 6 degrees. Here, in the exponent place, if you keep one line, single line, it is called minute. Single line, like apostrophe. One single apostrophe, if you keep, it is called as minute. Single quote, minute. So 360 degrees equal to 60 minutes, where each minute equal to 6 degrees. Each minute equal to 6 degrees. Okay. So that 60 minutes equal to into 6 degrees equal to 360 degrees. So again, this 1 minute part, again it is divided into 60 equal parts. Again it is divided into 60 equal parts, and each part, this 1 minute, each part equal to 60 seconds. Double quotes or two lines or two apostrophes, two quotes, 60 seconds. So 1 minute equal to 60 seconds, where 1 second equal to 6 minutes. Sorry, not 6 minutes. 1 minute. Now this one you can strike off. So 1 degree equal to 60 minutes. Sorry, 60 seconds. 1 minute, right? Sorry. 1 minute. 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. So that 60 minutes equal to 60 minutes into 60 seconds. 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So 3600 seconds. 3600 seconds. So 360 degrees equal to 60 minutes equal to 3600 seconds. Or we can better to remember this one. One rotation equal to 360 degrees. 1 degree equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. Based on this, so whatever measurement we want, that we can convert from one form to another form. So angle also defined as a rotation by a single ray about its vertex. If it has made complete rotation, then it is called a complete angle, which is equal to 360 degrees. Degrees are further divided into minutes. Minutes are further divided into seconds. So here, children, one rotation. So one rotation equal to 360 degrees. 1 degree 60 minutes. 1 minute 60 seconds. If the starting point is, if it is at starting point, this is the OA ray. If it is at starting point without any rotation, then that angle is called zero angle, because there is no rotation. The angle made by the ray is 0 degrees. So that's why it is called zero angle. Or if it has made 1/4 rotation, 1/4 rotation from OA, if its position is at OB, then it has completed 1/4 of the circle, means out of 360 parts, 360 degrees, it has 360 degrees means one part. It has covered 1/4 part of one rotation. 1/4 part of one rotation means 1/4 part of 360 degrees, which is equal to 90 degrees, or which is called right angle. Next. If it is like this, means it has completed half rotation. It has completed half rotation, means half into 360 degrees, 2 into 180. So 180 degrees. The angle is formed on a straight line. This 180 degrees angle. So that's why it is called as a straight angle. Or if it has completed 3/4 of rotation, 3/4 into 360, 4 into 90, 360, 90 into 3, 270 degrees. So it is more than 180 degrees. So that's why it is called reflex angle. More than 180 degrees means it is called reflex angle. Or if it has made one complete rotation and again came back to position A, so then it is called one complete rotation, or 360 degrees angle, or complete angle. So this is about angle and its parts, rotation and its parts. Next, we have types of angles. So we have mainly three types of angles based on the measurement. So one is acute angle, another one is obtuse angle, third one is reflex angle. So acute angle means an angle whose measurement is between 0 degrees and less than 90 degrees. Actually, this is 90 degrees. So this is 0 degrees. Between 0 and 90, any angle is considered as acute angle. Means from starting point to 1/4 of the complete rotation, below that, so whatever rotation made by the ray is considered as acute angle. So greater than 0 degrees, less than 90 degrees, it is called as acute angle. So next, obtuse angle. So obtuse angle means, so whose measurement is greater than 90, this 0 degrees, this 90 degrees, so this is a 180 degrees, greater than 90 means this angle or this angle or this one, this angle greater than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees, if it is like that, so then it is called obtuse angle. Then that angle is called obtuse angle. So, or if this is 0 degrees, this is 90 degrees, this is 180 degrees, this 0 degrees after complete rotation, it is also considered as 360 degrees. If the angle made by the ray is, suppose this is the angle, this is the angle, it is greater than 180 degrees, or this angle greater than 180, or this angle greater than 180. This angle in a anti-clockwise direction. Suppose if you take this angle, if you take like this angle, in clockwise direction, it is acute angle. But if you take like this angle, because here 12, 3, 6, 9 will be there. If you measure like this, this direction is called anti-clockwise direction. We are going against the clock direction. In anti-clockwise direction, it is obtuse angle. Its angle is more than 180 degrees. If the angle is greater than 180 degrees, less than 360 degrees, so then it is called reflex angle. Like this, mainly we have three types of angles here: acute angle, obtuse angle, reflex angle. Next, adjacent angles. So, in pair of angles, our next concept is pair of angles. In that, we have about adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. So, if you observe the figure, this figure, in this figure, we have OA ray, OB ray, OC ray. Their common initial point is O. Their common initial point is O. Or this is called, if we consider this AOB, if we consider this AOB angle, this O is the vertex of angle AOB, and if we consider BOC, O is also the vertex of BOC angle. So this O is the common vertex of both AOB angles and BOC angles, AOB angle and BOC angle. And OB is the common arm in both the angles. Means they have common vertex and they have one common arm. But their interior parts, their interior parts, they don't have any points in common. This interior part, they are completely different. Only the common arm is acting like boundary between them. No other point is in common. So we call this kind of angles as adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. These types of angles as adjacent angles. So this angle AOB and angle BOC are called adjacent angles, means one after another, means next to angle AOB is next to BOC, or angle BOC is next to angle AOB. Okay, next. Suppose if you see this one, so here QSR, this one, Q is the common point, RQP, Q is the common point, and QR is the common arm. So SQR and RQP are the adjacent angles, because this interior, they don't have any common point, and they have one common vertex and common arm, so that's why they are adjacent angles. So adjacent angles means they are pair of angles with the common vertex, common side, but have interiors with no points in common. Next we have linear pair. So in the figure, in this figure, AOC, this part is AOC, angle AOC, BOC, this part is BOC, O is the common vertex and OC is the common side or common arm. This interior, they don't have any points in common. So these two angles are considered as adjacent angles. And OA, OB are non-common arms. OA and OB are non-common arms, but they are opposite rays. They are lying on the same straight line, but in opposite manner. So they are considered as opposite rays. So this kind of pair of angles, this kind of pair of adjacent angles are called linear pair. If they have common vertex, common side, with no interior points common, but non-common arms are opposite arms, so then that adjacent angles form a linear pair. So AOB is a straight line, OA, OB are opposite rays. So AOB is a straight line, so angle AOB equal to 180 degrees. So angle AOC plus BOC equal to 180 degrees means the sum of linear pair of angles. If two angles form a linear pair, their sum is always equal to 180 degrees. So if in linear pair, if one angle is 30, because they form a linear pair, other angle will be 150. So that 30 plus 150 will be 180. Like that. Okay, children, that's all for today, children. So remaining topics we can learn in our next video. So thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates. You can also visit our website, children, aimstoday.in, for information regarding online classes, quizzes, worksheets, activities, English classes, coding skills. Thank you, children. Have a good day.